Okay,
here we go.
There we go. Many years later.
Here we are again.
Present day, out of our time machine. Okay. Crazy. Okay, with us once again is my dear friend, Fran Capo. She's with us. I know you just saw her recently with Hopeville, but she wrote another book. I mean, like, she wrote another book, she published it, and she's here. She's quick. So she's prolific. I think just words just kind of fly out of her mouth as well as out of her head and on through her fingertips, but she is with us, and it's called The Humor Approach. Is that correct?
Yes.
All right. What is the humor approach of your newest book? What is this?
Okay. You know what it is? It's like, all right, right now, perfect time to give an example of this.
Okay.
People have to do toasts for weddings, or they have to, you know, do a speech, or, they go to a prom. Well, nobody's speaking at a prom, but, you know, they're speaking at a graduation, whatever, and they don't know how to add humor into it. When they don't know simple things, like, for example, if you're giving a wedding toast, somebody goes up, they start speaking. The people of the place don't know who it is. You know, you need to introduce yourself. You need to say something that would be funny, but a story that's not going to embarrass, you know, the future other side of the family.
Yeah, nothing
you
rude.
Yeah, well, funny. You know, right. If it was a small, intimate group, you know. And then you need to make them the star of the speech and keep it to 4 minutes. So what the humor approach, putting a funny side up, does, it's a guide to humor and business speaking in everyday life. And literally the way that it came about was a couple of weeks ago, I got called by Barnes & Noble, and they said, hey, we want you to be on a comedy panel. We're doing this nationwide thing for teens to get them into reading. So they said, you know, you do a lot of TV, you do a lot of radio, would you? I was like, yeah, sure. And I said, hey, can I bring my Hopeville book? They said, well, is it about humor? I went, no. I said, I'll do another panel then at 3 to 4 about Hopeville. They said, but do you have a book on humor? I went, well, what I got, 2 weeks? I'll write one. And so she goes, what do you mean? I said, I'll get an ISBN number, I'll write one. So I had a cartoonist work on the cover. I had a different cartoonist work on the crowd. I had my friend Jeanette did the editing. I had someone else editing the back of the book. I had my web mistress doing it. We submitted it to the publisher, turned around, got the book on a Wednesday. The book was registered into Barnes & Noble, and I did my talk on that Saturday.
Fran, literally, the ink's not even dry, man.
I know, right, exactly. Not really ink. No,
this is actually amazing. I'm so, you know, I love you. You're awesome. I'm proud to know you. I know our audience loves you, and you're known all over the world. So this makes book number what?
19.
19. Okay.
Yeah.
So book 19.
Yes.
Right? Okay. But you didn't have a book about humor.
No.
And they requested it, and so you wrote one.
Well, yes.
Yeah, there you go.
Because in my head, I always go like this. Is this, can I do it? And you know that moment in life when you, like when I bungee jump or when I do all the different, I always go, if you're going to do this, just commit.
Okay.
And then I go, you're going to do this? I hear you inside. So I said the word star. I actually gave her the title and the ISBN number before I even finished writing the book. And then I went, submit it into your system. Don't worry, it'll be there. She goes, you'll definitely have it. And I didn't tell her that I didn't have the cover.
Right.
I didn't have anything yet. I just said, nah, it'll be there. And then
this is reminiscent of another story that I know.
Yes.
And I think we should just mention it.
Yes.
Because it's the exact same philosophy you used when you broke the world record.
Oh, I didn't know that was the one you were talking. Yes.
But, oh, no, there's so many of the Fran stories. Yeah. But I mean, this is the epitome of who Fran Capo is.
It's just say yes and figure it out later.
Exactly.
And when
you broke the world record, so somebody called you. It was a radio station. And they said, well, what are you going to do? And you said, oh, I'm the fastest talking Guinness Book of World Records holder.
Well,
blah, 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 blah.
Actually, I was working at a radio station.
Okay.
I was working at a radio station, WBLS-FM in New York City. And I was, writing comedy for them and kidding around. And I said to the DJ, hey, I could do a really cool Mae West impression. But I call the character Junice, Mae West's long-lost sister. So all of a sudden, he flings the weather and traffic, you know, copy at me. The little red tally light comes on. So I'm like, oh, okay, you know, oh, today the weather and traffic is. And in the 30 seconds I happened to do it, a lady from the Daily News called and said, oh, how long have you been doing that weather and traffic thing? And I'm like, oh, a long time. Wasn't going to tell 30 seconds. So I was like, yeah, I've been doing it. So she goes, what are you planning on doing next? And I'm like, next. I just did this. So then I said, I can't tell you. She goes, well, if you're going to tell me the article, it's going by 6 o'clock today. I went out. I looked, you know, in the Guinness book, you know, and I was like, you know, all right, I'll tell her I'm breaking a world record. Told her I was breaking a world record. Found fast talking. I said, hey, I always talk fast. She had a limo. She printed in the paper that I'm going to go to break the world record. within 5 hours, I had a limo at my house because she had printed it in the paper, went to the Larry King live show. And when Larry King called me, the very first thing he said was, I heard that them say, this is a cable show. And at that time I went, cable? Is this some kind of porn thing? They're like, honey, no, this is a national show. I said, what if I'm gonna break the record? Said, Larry doesn't care whether you break it or not, just cares that you come on the show and do it. So I practiced for 5 hours, went on the show, and broke the record doing 585 words a minute, and then I rebroke it at the Guinness Museum in Vegas doing the 602.32 words a minute, which is 11 words a second.
11 words a second.
Yeah.
Got it. I heard you very clearly.
You always get me.
My brain must listen at the same rate that you're able to speak.
That's right.
I must speak Fran. Thank you for being here. So how can people get this Humor Approach book?
Right now, the easiest way is go to my website, francapo.com, okay. Click the cover, and if anything has to do with public speaking, if you want to be funny as a comic, as a teacher, any type of public speaking, it gives you everything. How to deliver the joke, how to, the timing, how to deliver a persona. So francapo.com, you get the book, I autograph it, I send it to you.
I love it.
That's it.
Great. Well, happiness to you always.
Thank
and
you.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fran Capo. Two words, that's all you need to know, Fran Capo. All right, thanks for watching Live It Up. This really is, I am genuinely proud of you.
Like,
I find your zestiness